Whenever we conduct a research study and compute statistical results, we report those results in something called a results section. So I'm going to outline a little bit what goes into results sections. The first thing we put in our results sections are descriptive statistics. For example, the mean and standard deviation. The descriptive statistics represent the heart of our study. This tells us exactly what happened in our study and should always be reported. And we can report those in three ways. We can report them in text. In other words, we put them right in between our words in our results section. We can put them in graphs, such as a bar graph, or we can put them in tables. Next, we'll want to report our inferential statistics. And this is either a hypothesis test or a confidence interval, or sometimes both. So in reporting a hypothesis test, you want to give the reader the following pieces of information. You want to tell the reader what kind of test did you conduct. For example, a one-sample t-test. Next, you want to give the actual value of the test statistic. For example, the value of t. Then you provide the degrees of freedom of the test. Not the formula, but the actual number that comes from the formula. You also want to give the reader the p-value, specifically the exact p-value if possible. Next, if applicable, give the direction of the test. For example, is it a one-tailed test or a two-tailed test? And always provide the alpha level. Always let the reader know what alpha level you used to make your decisions. For many disciplines, we use APA style to report the results of our hypothesis tests. APA stands for American Psychological Association. The APA has a whole guide on writing research papers. And one of the parts of that guide tells us how to write our inferential statistical results. I'm going to give you a little brief introduction to APA style for statistics as it relates to the t-test. So here's a generic outline of how to present the results of a t-test in APA style. First, we put the test statistic name. In this case, it's t. Next to that, we put the degrees of freedom in parentheses. We put an equal sign. Then we provide the t-value, rounded to two decimal places, with a comma. Then we give the p-value, again rounded to two decimal places. There are some exceptions to this rule, but for the most part, this is how you do it. And then we put another comma, and we tell the direction of the test, whether it's one-tailed or two-tailed. I'll give you a more concrete example in a little bit. Imagine a situation in which we have a t-value with 24 degrees of freedom equals negative 2.50. If we're doing it by hand, we only know whether the p-value is less than or greater than 0.05, and we have a one-tailed test. This is how you'd write it out. If we used a computer to get these results, we'd end up with an exact p-value. And the exact one-tailed p-value for this situation, rounded to two decimal places, is 0.01. So in that case, we could actually put p equals 0.01.